Hi, I'm Spencer Matthews, and as part of Hi, I'm Spencer Matthews, and as part of Heat Making You Happy in January, here is my guide on how to be successful in a relationship. Point number one of how to be successful in a relationship is communication. Without communication, you effectively have nothing. And, you know, who cares whether you text them first? Games are overrated. Everybody plays games nowadays. Ooh, I'm going to wait until she texts me or he texts me. I reckon if you've got something to say, just say it. And also let your girlfriend know where you are at all times. Point number two of the guide is arguments. Arguments happen inevitably, regardless of whether you're the world's best boyfriend or the world's worst boyfriend, or vice versa with the girls. I personally think try not to argue in public. If you are going to argue in public, do it down by the river. The third group in this topic is friends. Friends always come first, unless they sleep with your ex-girlfriend. Then you just go on a trip and sort stuff out. Yeah, more recently it was Miami, but anywhere works. The fourth topic in the discussion is money. Now, although money isn't very important in a relationship, I believe that it's important for a man to pay for a woman, to treat a woman right, because it's just how kind of gentlemen are brought up. It's what is expected of a young gentleman. Number five, rules of sex. Sex is extremely important in a relationship, personally. I think that, you know, if you have bad sex with someone, it can be quite off-putting and could jeopardize the future of the relationship. But I've been quite lucky with my girlfriend, so never really had that problem. We're all good. Okay, number six, sex on a first date. It kind of comes down to the couple's like maturity and just whether or not, you know, if you know it's going to happen and you both have a very strong chemistry over dinner and you know, and it's you're obviously going to see each other again and you're probably going to have sex and it just happens, then that's fine. I would imagine that the girl that I end up marrying, no, I probably won't sleep with each other on the first date, but if we do, good for us or me or her or however you want to look at it. Sex on the first date, I don't think it's a turn off. I think, you know, wanting, like striving towards something and not being able to have it often helps in the early stages of a relationship when you want something more. So, you know, if it is offered up on a plate, then perhaps not ideal. Number seven, rules of living together. I think timing is quite an important one. I've lived with a few of my girlfriends now. God, it's happened really quickly. since Funda was my first, and that was great. We lived together for nearly a year, but that took a lot of deciding. I think, you know, when you get into the habit of seeing someone and they spend more and more time at your house, and then all of a sudden they have a set of keys and they kind of live there, it's a conversation you should have as opposed to something that just happens, because sometimes it doesn't go so well. The next topic of discussion is cheating. Don't do it. And if a relationship, you know, is in turmoil and you want to get out of it, just try and be honest. Have a conversation with your loved one or ex-loved one. And, you know, take that chat before you do something stupid. As far as I'm concerned, nothing screams guilt like a gift. So wait for her birthday or Christmas, because otherwise you've probably done something wrong. I don't believe in showering people with gifts. I think it's kind of material goods that are welcome, I guess, but yeah, save it for a special occasion. How about you?